Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, compound interest examples, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone to the today's session. It's a financial modeling class, basically a financial modeling topic, and when you do financial modeling, you need Excel, and when Excel comes into picture, we do Excel modeling where these kind of concepts come into picture. Well, as you can see, the compound interest formula, A is equal to P into 1 plus R divided by M raised to MT, right? So P is the initial investment of, basically the initial investments, R is the rate of interest, 10%, the number of times it is compounded, let's say it's just for 1 year, and the T, M into T, the number of investments, number of years. So how many times? It can be quarterly, it can be half yearly, it can also be, you know, daily basis. So depending upon the compounding process, this M is decided. The number of years of investments is 3. So this is how the future value comes into picture. So the example of that compound interest formula, it provides an understanding of various type of situations where the compound interest formula can be used. So in case of compound interest, interest is earned not only on the principal amount, remember this thing, which is invested initially, but it is also earned on the interest, that is the interest portion, that is interest earned previously from the investment. So there are different numbers of periods for which the compounding of the interest can be done, which depends upon the terms and the conditions of the investments. And the compounding can be done, as I told you, it can be done daily, it can be done monthly, then quarterly, semi-annually, annually, and so on and so forth. So we can see some different type of compound interest formula examples so that you have an all-around view regarding this particular topic. Now, what are the case? Let's go with example number one. Let's say Mr. Z makes an initial investment of $5,000 for a period of 3 years. Find the value of the investment after 3 years. If the investment earns a return of, let's say, 10%, and it is compounded monthly. Okay, so that comes to 12, right? So in order to calculate the value of the investment after the period of 3 years of annual compound interest, the following formula will be used. Well, let me just note down here. A is equal to P 1 plus R divided by M raised to MT, right? I forgot to specify here, raised to psi. A is the future value of the investment that is to be calculated. P is the initial investment, that is $5,000 here in our example. R, the rate of interest of return, that is 10%, which is compounded annually. Your M here, your M is the number of times it is compounded. 1. T will be the number of years for which the investment is done. 3 years, right? So, this is my P. What I'll do, just shift everything here. Saying this is my P, the initial investment. This is my R of the formula. My M, that is the number of times compounded annually. I'll just shift this up. M, let's say I'll take it as 1. The format as number. And final is the T, that is the number of years of investments. 3. So what is going to be my A here? I'll just put down the formula here. So, is equal to your P into, please remember the formula very well. There shouldn't be any sort of if or buts here. can lead to wrong answer. Okay, plus R raised to M. Now when I talk about M is the number of times. So my future value will be 6655. Right? Now, here if you see, this is, if you see 1 plus 0.10, okay, divide by 1. So this whole formula, if you see, it is formulated in such a way that it has been compounded in a way we want. So it shows that the value of the initial investment of 5,000 here, after the period of 3 years, will become 6,655 when the return of the investment is 10%, which is compounded annually. Let me take example number 2. Let's say Mr. X makes an investment of 10,000 for a period of 5 years. Let me just quote the entire thing, then I'll write the denominations. Find the value of the investments after 5 years if the investment earns a return of 3%, that is compounded monthly. So in order to calculate the value of the investment after the period of 5 years, compounded interest formula on monthly basis will go something like this. Your R is 3%, right? Already told you that. Now your M is the number of times that has been compounded. So what is the number of times? 12, because it's getting compounded monthly. Then comes your T, that is the number of years for which the investment is done, that is 5 years. Now we need to calculate the formula here is equal to your amount, that is your P, into 1 plus your R, divide by, be very sure what you are doing it, divide by 12. Okay, this is just one bracket. Before that, just make sure that you are keeping this in a separate bracket, raised to, comma, number of times 12 into 5. When you do, you'll get a different answer. So it shows that the value of the initial investments of the 10,000 after the period of 5 years will become 11,612 when the return is 3% compounded monthly. So when I'm saying that the compounding portion is, let's say, for monthly, the amount will be higher. If it is yearly, it's going to be lesser than the monthly compounding. So I'll give you that relation in a further course. Let me give you more example to make you understand this particular thing. Example number 3. Let's say Finn International Limited makes an initial investment of 10,000 for a period of 2 years. What you need to do is to find the value of the investments after 2 years if the investment earns a return of 2% compounded quarterly. Again, the same thing, you just need to pick up all the coordinates. Try and paste it here and let's put down all the numbers. 10,000, this is 2%. Then you have your M, that comes to around 4 because compounded quarterly, 4 quarters in a year. T is your 2 years. So what's going to be your answer? Well, quite simple. 10,000, right? 1 plus R. Divide by the amount of the quantum of your compounding, raised to, again open one more bracket, M into, well, your answer is here 10407.07. So it shows that the value of the investment of $10,000 after the period of 2 years will become 10,407 when the return is 2% compounded quarterly. let's do another example. Now, Mr. Y invested $1,000 during the year 2009. After the period of 10 years, he sold the investment for $1,600 in the year of 2019. What you need to do is you need to calculate the return on investment if it is compounded yearly. So, in order to calculate the return on investment after the period of 10 years, the compound interest formula will be used something in this particular format. A, that is here, your future value is 1600. You are already given your P, that is your initial value of the investment. That is, so here, your P is already given as a part of 1000. This is which is supposed to be calculated. You have been given M, that is 1, and then T is the number of times for which the investment is to be done, that is over the course of 10 years. You just have to rearrange the entire formula. There's nothing to be worried about anything. You first have to take the future value is equal to, we are finding R. So finding R, you will take the future value. This, the formula remains the same, it's just interarranging the entire thing. The future value divided by the current value, that is the initial investment that you are going to make, raised to, one more thing, just open two brackets here so that we can, okay, raised to the number of times divided by your T. Close one more bracket. Make sure here there is one more bracket. Close the second bracket, minus 1. You will get your percentage as 5. That is 4.81. So thus it shows that Mr. Y earned a return of 4.81% compounded yearly with the value of the initial investment of 1000 when sold for the period of 10 years. So it can be seen that the compound interest formula is a very useful tool in calculating the future value of an investment. Using the other information available, it is used in the case of interest is earned by the investors on principal as well as the previously earned interest part of the investment. So in case when the investments are done where the return is earned using compound interest, then these kind of formulas help you over there calculating the investment growth. And you know, the return in it earned using compound interest, these type of investment grow very quickly as the interest is earned on the previously earned interest as well. However, one can determine how quickly the investment grows only on the basis of the rate of return and the number of compounding periods. So always remember, the daily compounding value will always be greater than the monthly compounding. Your monthly compounding will be absolutely be bigger than quarterly compounding, then your half yearly, and last but not least. So this is the entire relation. I hope you guys have got a fantastic learning about this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session.